All right. Also, too, like I said, I designed it for the half-inch operation. It still has the power. These are the same magnets from my short tracks, and it still has the power to move the large half-inch chrome steel ball. And this compared to, yeah, that's a 3/4 inch chrome steel ball to a 1/2 inch chrome steel ball from Arbor Scientific. And it still has the power to move my 3/4 inch balls. And that's the motion, like I was discussing, when it gets stuck like a spring. And I can make both of these operate in a 3/4 inch lift. So what happened was, is I originally built a 6-inch design, was able to achieve maybe a 1/4 inch lift. I couldn't get any higher. No matter how I adjusted the magnetic field or the magnets. So I made the ramps longer. Noticed I could now get at least a 1/2 inch. And then the even longer and stronger. So now I got higher and higher amounts of lift. So in continuing on this incline, I've determined that if I make, here's my 4-foot track. As you can see, this is, I've just now got it put together. These are 2-foot tracks. Two 2-foot tracks. My 4-foot track, of course, doesn't have magnets in place. I haven't completely the construction. I noticed I've got a new issue that never appeared with the shorter tracks. Here the tracks actually move independently, so I'm going to have to make those sturdier. The smaller ones, the actual angled aluminum, were riveted at the center, so the inner track wasn't able to move at all. It stayed at the same angle. It stayed at the even. So I believe if I get this 4-foot track, I will be able to obtain the 3/4 inch to the 1 inch of lift required to join 2 magnetic tracks. And I believe if I can do it, I have already done it with the 2-foot tracks. That's where I realized that you need 3/4 inches of separation from one magnetic field to the other. But you'll see they're regular magnets. Neodymium. One more.